So good morning everyone. I am here today because we will continue our discussion. But before that, let us pray first. So Cedric, please lead the prayer.
Okay po. So let us pray po. Our Father who are in heaven, holy be your name, thy kingdom come, your will be done. Please guide us for today and may you bless us, keep us, and we're asking for the guidance and knowledge we needed for this class. May the teacher and the students learn and cooperate with each other. We are nothing without you, Lord. All these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. So next slide. Good morning, everyone. So how are you today?
Okay lang po, ma'am. Kayo po?
So, okay lang din naman ako. So, sana nag-enjoy ko yung ngayong araw.
Okay lang po, ma'am.
Good to know. So, I will now tell about our classroom management or our household rules. Next slide, please. So, classroom management. So, please open your camera and mic only if necessary. Cooperate accordingly and always respect each we will now proceed to our attendance. Just say present if you are here. So, Alin Laluces?
Present!
Cedric Rosas?
Present po.
Dana Ilagan?
Present po, ma'am.
Emerlyn Hunat?
Present po, ma'am.
Erica Buendia?
Present
so, you are all present. So, last time, we had our discussion about prepositional phrase. So, can someone give me the definition of it?
Ako po, ma'am.
Okay, go, Mr. Cedric.
So, what I can remember po from our last discussion is a prepositional phrase po is a group of words that begins with a preposition and ends with a noun, pronoun, or non-phrase po.
So, very good. Last time, we tackled about prepositional phrase, and today, we will have a new topic. But before that, we will have an icebreaker. So, please react a heart emoji if you are ready. Our icebreaker is all about two picks and one phrase. Next slide, please. Can someone answer the first slide? Okay, Miss Dana Ilagan.
Cloud 9 po.
Very good. So the correct answer is Cloud 9. Next slide, please. Ayun. Okay, Mr. Cedric.
Break a leg po, ma'am.
Very good. That's correct. Okay, Miss Allen, please answer the last slide.
Piece of cake po, ma'am.
Very good. That's also correct. So, did you guys enjoy our icebreaker?
Yes, po.
Yes, po.
So I'm glad to hear that. Now, those pictures can be understood both literally and figuratively. So what do you mean by that? Literal language means exactly what the words say, like piece of cake, or referring to an actual piece and a cake. So figurative language, on the other hand, is more complex and uses metaphorical or symbolic meanings. So our topic for today is all about figurative language or figure of speech. And I have here a scrambled words and you need to fix it. Are you ready, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So please answer the number one, Miss Allen. Number two, Dana. Number three, Erica. And number four, Cedric. Please use the chat box na lang po. Salamat! Very good. Number four, correct. Number one, correct. Number two, correct. And number three, correct. Number one, simile. Number two, metaphor. Number three, personification. And number four, hyperbole. So settle down and we will now move forward to our discussion. Simile. So a simile is a figure of speech that compares two different things using the words like or as to show similarities. It helps make descriptions more interesting and vivid. So here is the example of simile. So here's the example of simile. Her smile is as bright as the sun. So there is a comparison and there is the word as. So here is the word as and there is a comparison with her and the sun. The other one will be the house stood tall like a mountain. So there is also a comparison and there is the word like. There is a comparison between the house and the mountain. The next one will be metaphor. So a metaphor is a figure of speech that describes something by saying it is something else. It's like a hidden comparison that helps us understand and imagine things in a new way. So here is an example of metaphor. Life is a roller coaster with its ups and downs. So it only means that life will lead you to happiness and grief. The next one will be the classroom was a zoo during group project. So it only means that the classroom is a mess during a group project. Next one will be personification. So personification is a figure of speech that gives human characteristics or qualities to non-human things or animals. It helps us imagine them as if they were humans, making descriptions more engaging. So the example of personification is the flowers dance in the breeze. So it gives human characteristics to a flower because it says that the flower dance in a breeze. The next one will be the sun smiled down on us. It also gives human characteristic to sun because of the word smiled. The next one will be hyperbole. So hyperbole is a figure of speech that uses exaggeration to make a point or create effect. It's when we say something that is intentionally over the top and not meant to be taken literally. Example of hyperbole will be, I'm so hungry, I could eat a horse. So it gives exaggeration because of the word, I could eat a horse. The next one will be, I've told you a million times to clean your room. It also gives exaggeration to the word million times. Okay, class, what are those figure of speech again? Raise your hand if you want to answer. Okay, Allen?
Simile, ma'am.
Simile. And Miss Dana?
Metaphor po.
Okay, Mr. Cedric?
Hyperbole po.
Very good. And Miss Dana again?
Personification po, ma'am.
Thank you. So very good. Very good. So figure of speech are composed of simile, metaphor, personification, and hyperbole. So let's test. If you listen carefully, we will have an activity and you will just comment in the chat box your answers. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So for number one, life is a roller coaster with its ups and downs. So comment the answer in the chat box if it is simile, metaphor, personification, or hyperbole. I will reveal the answer later. Okay, for the number two, her smile is as bright as the sun. Comment down your answers. And number three, this line is taking forever. I've been waiting for ages. Comment down your answers. And for the last one, the stars wink at me from the night sky. Okay, I will now reveal the answer. For the number one, it is metaphor. Number two, simile. Number three, hyperbole. And number four, personification. So you are all very good because you got perfect answers. So for the last part, you will have an assignment which is give each figure of speech at least 3 examples. So I will collect your assignment tomorrow. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, po.
Please react on heart emoji if that's clear. If that's clear, class dismissed. Thank you for listening and cooperating. Thank you.
Thank you for.